Logan, Utah, kicking off the Utah State Aggies, and it is Allen Amundsen deep in the end zone. And one of the biggest crowds in Utah State history expected for this one. They're still filling in as Maurice Morris takes the handoff and met by a host of Aggies.
Need to get it going. The main thing, Maurice Morris. We expect him to get 20-25 carries tonight. He looked better last week. And now on the outside, Keenan Howery, of course, has been great all the way through.
And on the line, Chambers, Schmidt, Weaver starting at center. Forster, that is. And Phil Finger, the right tackle. And this is Morris again, this time a first down and more. Across the 35-yard line to the 37.
A lot of points last week against Wyoming. The Cowboys scored on 9 of 10 possessions. That's an amazing number. Here's the defense. You can see the linebacker with the great name, Jesse Busto.
Perfect.
We'll see how he acts tonight. And also in the secondary, Tony Walker, the main player from Lancaster, California.
And all four starters in the secondary return, but they have struggled nonetheless. All right, first down for Oregon at the 36. Morris again up the middle, and we talked about getting him going in the first three plays. So Oregon trying to take advantage of that early. And the belly toss. Morris again gets outside, but a nice play there. And a little bit of noise here at Romney Stadium and a train whistle in the background. Harrington will throw. Complete, but short of the first down.
And a penalty flag here. Something they'll have to deal with here tonight.
Not a real penalty, though, in the altitude here. Arroyo should be able to get his foot into this one. High kick, but short. And White will make a fair catch at the 26-yard line. Nice to see him take a fair catch. Weimart starting lineups on offense for Utah State. Emmett White, we talked about him in the open. And he is the leading all-purpose yard gainer in the NCAA. Kevin Curtis leads the NCAA in receptions. Newton, Shuck, Powell, Walker, and William. Four seniors on that offensive line, very experienced. And on first down, Fuentes will throw deep. Right side.
Got a flag down. They're not going to get any favors. When you come to a stadium like this, that's the way it is. Oregon State dealt with it when they went to Fresno State a few weeks ago. And Oregon's going to have to deal with it tonight. And
it's holding on the defense, automatic first down.
It's what Mike Bellotti talked about all week long, that when you go on the road, you have to play better than the home team because you're fighting more than just the home team. The crowd, sometimes the officials. That play right there wasn't a lot of contact. And if that's the kind of coverage they're going to have, Oregon could be in a little bit of trouble.
And Oregon's defense has played well, basically, this season. In the first three games, they've given up some big plays. That's been the problem, but very solid overall. So it's a first and 10 at the 36.
Look at this formation.
Look at that.
Four wide outs, bringing one in motion.
One of the things Mike Lottie talked about is the weird formations, all the different things they do to make it hard to prepare.
Stump blitzes. And today, though, I think they might drop off a little bit, see what they can get with four guys.
On second and 10. Fake to White. Fuentes, near side. Over the head of his tight end.
See Zach Frater playing very well so far this year. Ed Wangler getting a start at defensive end today. Chris Tedderton, the former walk-on from Sheldon High School. Great linebackers. David Moretti played a great game against USC. Kevin Mitchell runs to the ball as well as Wesley Mallard does. Rashad Bowman, Smith, Webster, Keith Lewis, a great secondary, maybe the best in the Pac-10.
Certainly playing like it. Steve Smith, we mentioned him. Pac-10 Defensive Player of the Week. Three interceptions last week against USC. On third and 10, pressure on Fuentes. Has to get rid of it. And tackled as soon as it's caught. Rashad Bowman up there, one of the leading tacklers. And Keenan Howery, the junior, deep for the Ducks. Inside his own 20. Ready for a deep one. Very good punter. Steve Mullins for Utah State. And fumbles the football and jumped on it. I think Howery got it back.
Recovery.
And the Ducks take over on their own 6-yard line. More from Logan, Utah when we return. So maybe no advantage for the home team. All right, first and 10, and here they come. And Morris on the carry across the 10. Some breathing room for Oregon. Nice pickup
to the second half.
And again, at altitude, we'll have to see how he holds up fatigue-wise. Again, it's Morris, far side, going for the first down marker. Believe it's the 17-yard line. We talked about maintaining intensity, and it's tough to create your own emotion sometimes in a stadium like this. They had 27,000 here last week, their eighth largest crowd ever. And Oregon used to playing in the noise, especially the last 3 weeks at home. Complete to Willis. And not much there.
You've got Gary Coleman and Willis. Well, what you talking about Willis?
What you talking about? Those different strokes, huh?
You know, the players jaw a little bit down there.
Morris, big room on the right side. And a flag comes down after Morris picks up a first down.
Holding by the offense. 10 yards from the penalty. It'll be second down.
Initially looked like a potential big gainer here for Morris, but the hold right on, must have been on Newsom there, I guess.
Boy, that's, if you can't block like that, then you can't block.
And they give to Morris, who stumbles, keeps his feet. Across the 20. Got most of that back up to the 23. Howery in motion. And Harrington rolling under pressure. Has Howery. Can he get to the first down marker? No. Got Keenan Howery, but players for Utah State there to make the tackle. It's Glasper. And the linebacker again, Tony Newsom.
It's a tough break again for Oregon to have a holding penalty, especially out front. You normally see holding on a pass or at the line of scrimmage, but not out front like that.
And another high kick from Arroyo. Not very deep, but deep enough to cause the fair catch again from Emmett White.
No score here midway through the first quarter. Oregon and Utah State.
They just got stopped on defense there. Joe, what happened there?
You see on the outside here, Mark, they're just going to come from the outside, and they get it right. Keenan Howery's going to kind of delay in here and slide out. Joey comes back and tries to hit him. And it's just the wrong play at the wrong time. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just a matter of they had the right setup and they had the pressure coming, and that's what stopped that play.
So Utah State takes over. Four receivers on the right. And the pass in the middle and snipped out. Very nice play. Doesn't hurt either. All right, on second and 12 for the Aggies. Still no carries for Emmett White. And there he is. And nothing doing. Kevin Mitchell. And Rasuli Webster.
See him down low. He's trying to go up field. Just a little belly play. And stepping up big. Kevin Mitchell filling the gap along with Rasuli Webster.
Third and 11. Fuentes in trouble and sacked.
Seth McEwen has been playing very well lately. You see him come up on the stunt. Loops around. Comes right up the gut after Fuentes, who's not a real mobile quarterback. He can't throw the ball, but if you can put pressure on him, 25, so I can't imagine they'd fake it.
Interesting. Howery has a chance to return this one. Across the 35 and brought down on a shoestring tackle. What a gorgeous night here in Logan. Man. Beautiful afternoon, and the weather's starting to cool off a little bit here in the 80s this afternoon, and supposed to get down into the 40s tonight as Oregon takes over. Third possession from its own 39. And Morris again. A couple of guys out there can't get past him. Still being very patient. Haven't gone downfield yet. Here we go. Harrington looking. Now throwing. And a little bit too far for Jason Willis.
He was offensive coordinator at Montana when Montana almost beat the Ducks back in 93 at Austin Stadium. 35-30. Oregon, again, third and long here. This is not where they want to be.
And nobody in the backfield for Harrington. And here they come, and throw is off and complete, but Peel once again brought down, short of the first down. Another three and out, and that's 0 for 3 so far on third down.
They had the rush coming, the blitz was on, but you'd like to see the ball thrown to the marker.
And a nice kick from Arroyo. Another fair catch for White at the 15, and the flag comes down, and here we go.
What's the infraction here? You get in there, he sees where he is, you'll see back up off of it.
Oh, that's my goodness.
More than 2 yards, and that is a terrible call. Flat out.
With the opportunity to make a catch.
Here you can see it. Yeah, 2 yards between here and here. Four penalties now for the Ducks. None for Utah State.
And no one in the backfield for the Aggies. And a throw on first down and complete. That's Gary Coleman. And Coleman is loose. Far sideline brought down by David Moretti.
Take another look at it, Mark. They're going to have a blown coverage. Get out in it. Moretti gets picked off. He gets stuck up the zone. Gets some good blocking on the outside, and it's a foot race. Oregon, of course, has the kind of speed to prevent some of those big gainers, but you make a mistake, this is the result.
Really amazing how quickly they all closed on him. Looked like Coleman was maybe going to get around the corner, and three Ducks caught right up. So it's a 28-yard pickup. Biggest play of this game so far, and Utah State maybe changing the play. Here's the give to White. Nice hole. Breaks the tackle. Not the start you wanted here in Oregon. And I know you and I both thought Oregon would crack the 40-point mark tonight, but they've got some work left to do that. Crowd growing a little restless here. And Fuentes trips and goes down.
How about that for luck? They finally get a penalty, and it's fortunate for them. It actually
prior
helps
to the snap, delay of game on the offense, second down. Please put 7 seconds back on the game clock.
Well, Wyoming did to Utah State last week. I don't think anybody would expect Oregon to come in here and struggle offensively like they have.
Fuentes under pressure has Emmett White out in the flat and a first down, but he had plenty of cushion.
Another look at it, White coming out of the backfield. McEwen sees it, reads it, but of course McEwen doesn't have the speed that Emmett White does, and he's able to get the first down.
Inside the Oregon 40. And reverse in the throwback. Kevin Curtis looking for the quarterback. Great coverage. Almost picked off by Bowman, but the flags came down almost immediately.
Need to do a little studying. Throwback pass. Oregon had it read perfectly. Rasuli Webster right on him all the way.
We have
four receivers down here on the offense. That penalty is declined. Second down.
Empty backfield on second and 10. And looking for the tight end. That's a lateral.
Ball is
alertly
live.
Picked it up. That's J.R. Zubituraga. All right, a third and 7. Good protection, good throw, complete, but short of the first down. Good defensive play.
Unbalanced line on the left side.
And the pitch to White. He'll try the far side, cuts it back, got the first down. Coming into this game with the negative yards, so they figured they had a pretty good shot with him, and they just had everybody blocked. And a nice cut back there. Bowman brought him down by the ankle. Harrington, the Oregon quarterback, coming into this one. Not going to overlook the Aggies despite their winless record this season.
This is very important because it's our first road trip, and we need to take this very seriously and learn how to play on the road. This is a good test for us. Utah State's a defense that does a lot of different things, and is showing a lot of different looks. And right now is something that's difficult to prepare for. So we need to be ready, and we are going to be ready.
First and 10 at the 27. As we begin play here in the second quarter. And the pump fake and the throw deep. Fuentes going to the end zone and knocked away. Steve Smith back on the coverage. Pac-10 Defensive Player of the Week this past week. And he has really come on, and they needed him.
Sprint out, you can see Steve Smith getting his arm in there. Fans wanted some interference, but no contact whatsoever. Great play by Steve Smith on the corner.
And here comes a flag as about 4 or 5 people were in motion for Utah State.
Substitution infraction on the offense. Second down.
On the ground, Oregon getting something going. 51 yards to only 6 for Utah State. Total yards just about even. First downs favor the Aggies thanks to this drive right here.
He's 4 of 5,
so 4 completions for 11 yards. All right, second and long. Fuentes, immediate pressure, gets it to Curtis. Now look out. Curtis might score. He does score. Utah State has the lead. And he does. And you take another look, and Frater all over Fuentes, who gets it off. And the Ducks were coming, Joe. Nobody was back there.
Nobody was there, and unfortunate because Fuentes, not only did they almost have a penalty at the snap, but he almost fumbled the ball. You see on another look, he kind of shuffled the ball as it came out. One man and he's gone, and he leads the country in receiving. It catches, third in yardage, and you know he's capable of doing it.
I tell you what, Zach Frater thought he had a sack here.
And that should serve as a pretty good wake-up call to get him going, especially offensively.
Kidman kicks it to Robinson. He'll bring it out to the 10. Stops short of the 20. Here's Morris. Tries the near side. Nice move.
Harrigan
got across the 25 and pulled out of bounds. And it also makes it easier on third down. Morris again. First down across the 30, and Moore still on his
Harrigan
feet.
Maybe some crossing routes. Get Keenan Howry on track. Jason Willis. They're going to run it again.
And that's Morris again and nowhere to go. And I think they're keying on number nine a little bit.
He's getting a lot of carries. That's for sure. They came into it looking to get Maurice some work, and they're definitely doing that. So it doesn't matter if you get 800 yards running if you don't score any points.
Second and 13. Harrington will throw it. Far side, Justin Peel bobbles it. He'll bring up a third and long.
This is the play they ran against Arizona State last year to the other side to win that football game to get it to overtime. And throw is right there. Justin just needs to come up with that catch.
Harrington under some heat, steps up, throws it far side, wide open. Sammy Parker, did he get his feet in? He did. Utah State territory, and Sammy Parker, talk about Oregon's speed, and it'd be tough to keep up with.
A little outside of the five-yard range there, but Sammy Parker keeping his feet in, pretty close.
Ooh, boy, very nice job there to keep the one foot in. Took the second one,
it's pretty close.
We'll call it a catch.
A little shuffle there on the sideline.
All right, first and 10 at the Utah State 42. And maybe that's the spark they needed. Harrington deep for Willis. Overthrow. And he will get the call. Tries the far side and nowhere to go. And the four receivers set. And a little shovel pass. Morris across the 35. Nice cut. Inside the 25.
Big against USC last year. You'll see Joey's just going to drop back. Morris slips underneath, and he does a good job getting himself upfield. Good vision, turns it up. Had a choice to make there, could have gone to the sideline, but he gets the yards, gets the first down. Now Oregon moving towards the red zone.
At the 24, Harrington. Wide open, Josh Line, touchdown.
It's too easy. And
to be honest, Josh Line has had some problems with those wide open plays, and this one he brought in and walked in.
Sneaks himself out of the backfield. Undiscovered. You don't expect Josh Line to get the ball a lot when Oregon has so many talent. What happened? They get the touchdown.
They have definitely woken up. Jared Siegel tacks it on, and we are tied. Very good foot. Perfect kick. Out of the end zone and out of bounds from the touchback. And here they go again. People moving all over the place for the Aggies on first and 10. And it's Emmett White up the middle. Flag comes down. Nice hole.
Holding on the offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. It'll be first down.
Mike Gilotti knew this was going to be a fight. He talked a lot about Utah State and how dangerous they are. And yes, they're 0-3, but they played a heads-up game at LSU earlier this year, 13th-ranked LSU, and lost that one by a couple of touchdowns. But this team has been right there in all the games they've played. They just haven't come out on top.
Fuentes throwing it deep. He's got Curtis in Oregon territory. Kevin Curtis.
Another look at it. Just going back straight post, really. Throws the ball 65 yards in the air. Shows you the kind of arm he has. Puts it right on the money.
Two catches, 84 yards, and a touchdown for Kevin Curtis. I tell you what, talk about shifts and momentum. Crossing pattern, Emmett White dropping. Big win for the Ducks there. Back in the football field, Emmett White tries the middle.
What
is he doing? Sully Webster,
White.
The last duck there. And the highest ranked team ever to play here in Logan, Utah, the Oregon Ducks at number 6.
Certainly not a stadium that's used to having big games here. This is the biggest one ever played here.
Under pressure, Fuentes lets it fly. Looked like some contact back there.
Had a look at it. We got an ISO for you. You can see it all the way down the field. And you can just make a judgment for yourself. Rashad Bowman hanging on to the shirt right there.
Oh, yeah. Hey, as long as it doesn't get called. Very sneaky. And Rashad Bowman, very rarely will you see the ball thrown his direction. And maybe that's part of why. He knows what he can do, what he can get away with. And a big defensive stand there for Oregon after the big play by Utah State. Little pooch kick. And out of bounds at the 11. Joey Harrington, very good percentage-wise. And they got it done last time. Here's Morris again. And that time, the Aggies had it sniffed out. Well, you mentioned, Joe, there are some Saturdays where upsets happen. So far, this hasn't been one of them, but have to hang around and find out. Great catch by Keenan Howery. Actually caught it twice.
Great catch by Keenan Howery as he comes over the middle. This is what you need out of your guy. You got second long. You don't want to get into a third long situation again. He just stays with it, pulls it down, and that's the kind of receiver. You know, Tony Hartley was like that a few years ago for the Ducks. When you really needed a tough catch, he made it. And Keenan Howery's doing that, and I would think that by the time his career is over at Oregon, he'll be the all-time receiving yardage leader for the Ducks.
All right, a first down for Oregon. Morris again, near side, tries to get the corner. Does, he got the first down and out of bounds.
The idea is to score points. Do it as fast as you can.
Well, and this was the game to do it, too. Harrington looking deep for Jason Willis. Caught and dumped by Tony Walker, and a great job of holding on, and Willis not getting up.
Mark, great job by Jason Willis to hang on to the ball. It's great to get the yardage, but you certainly worry about, wow, you worry about if he's okay. Came right down on his back.
Tell you what,
look at it.
Jason Willis has made a lot of big catches. Still has not caught a touchdown pass so far, but you know it's going to happen sooner or later. Very reliable receiver.
You know, and the fans here at Romney Stadium giving him a nice round of applause, but I don't think he's okay yet, Mark.
No, I think he's trying to get off on his own 2 feet and having a hard time trying to keep his balance here. A little groggy, I think.
Definitely.
Two catches in this ball game. That one a big one. Gets Oregon back into scoring position here at the 32 and a first down.
Onterio Smith into the football game for the first time at tailback. And he gets the ball.
And a flag comes down, and this one will...
On the offense, will be first down.
Just real fun to watch Onterio Smith go to work. Only a sophomore, and he will be fun to watch here the next couple of years. Takes at least 9 or 10 guys to bring him down. Just an amazing way of breaking tackles and staying on his feet. And that's 5 penalties on Oregon. First and 15, Harrington straight back. Throws it far side. Sammy Parker came back to the ball nicely.
Big play there. Sammy Parker is going to have to step up now with Jason Willis on the bench and his status unknown for the rest of the game. And Sammy Parker running him off with the speed there, coming back for it. DB makes a good break on the ball, but Sammy right there in a perfect throw for Joey Harrington.
Second and short. Harrington keeps the ball. Now he'll try to run for it. And he got it.
Ooh.
Just inside the 20 to get hit, but in the head's
not in the head
story.
Not like that, and not from behind, but you can see play action fake is a good one.
Very good. That one seems to work a lot. Joey has a real effective way of hiding that ball behind his hip. He's done that a couple of times this year. We're going to take control of this ball game. Out first down, Harrington. Wow, incomplete to Justin Peel. A little bit long and just about picked off back there.
It'll be first down.
9 penalties in this game so far, though. On first and 5, Smith has some room, has the first down, still on his feet.
Zone play, really. Ontario's going to take a look at it, see what these guys do, try to match up straight ahead. And Ontario's going to come out and just look for the zone, look for the seam, and find it. That's what he does. Ontario is very good on this zone play. It's something he ran a lot when he was at Tennessee, and after the transfer, does a good job getting upfield.
First and goal. It's Smith again. Still on his feet, chugging down to the 1. Carried about 4 guys.
Looking at a guy right there that's going to be around the Oregon program for 2 more years. Only a sophomore. And I know we had a little poll on the Oregon Football with Mike Velotti show last week, and a lot of people think that man right there is the best running back in the Pac-10. From what little they've seen of him.
That's
but
amazing.
When you see him, he is amazing. He really is, and I know a lot of folks are seeing him for the first time tonight. A lot of Oregon State fans who might be tuning in haven't seen Onterio run, but seeing what he does is nothing short of amazing, Mark, and it's great that Oregon has him for 2 more years.
Second and goal, Harrington over the top, stopped short. Jesse Busta, 3rd and goal at the 1. Oregon looking for the lead. Smith. Short. Take it down at the inch line.
Well, decision time for the Ducks. They're saying that he lost the football.
And I think if you're Oregon, you have to go for it here to make a point. stuff it right in. Good defensive work by the Aggies there. Gang tackling.
Not much
and
there.
Busta again.
See the ball come free there right at the end, but officials calling him down.
And a second effort touchdown.
They have not signaled
it
yet.
They have not
there
signaled, but there it is. It was easy for me to see from way up here. Puts Oregon in front here for the first time tonight.
Great presence of mind by Joey, though. You get stopped, he spins. It's the kind of thing we've talked about a lot, the kind of heart that he has, the intensity and the drive that he has to get himself into the end zone.
And my favorite thing is how he puts his arms up when he's laying on his back.
Yeah, that's the standard Harrington celebration.
Yep, we've seen that. Jared Siegel got the extra point. And Oregon leads this one 14-7. Another impressive drive capped off by Joey Harrington on fourth down. And the Ducks have their first lead. We're coming right back. And this one not quite as deep. Taken at the 2-yard line. It's White. And look out. Spins across the 25. To the 28.
On to kickoff. He used to do everything back.
And he's lined up wide now. Nobody in the backfield behind Fuentes on first down. And it's Curtis on the catch. White with a nice block and a first down. Backfield again. And a quick throw and incomplete. Firstly for the Ducks. Love to see a stand and tack on a few more and have a little more breathing room heading into the second half. And on second and 10, Fuentes, deep drop. And a deep throw over the middle. Going to be picked off. Keith Lewis. One man to beat, and he just runs right into Kevin Curtis.
Right at the last minute, he couldn't really decide which way he wanted to go, so he just ran right into Curtis. But you can see it's just a delay. They try to go to the tight end. They read it easily.
All over it.
Lewis picks it up, and, well, could have used the block from Steve Smith, but great field position for the Ducks. 47-yard line going in. Let's see if they try to hurt him early and go up top.
Those defensive guys not used to blocking. And so, pretty good return at the 47. Here's Morris. Tripped up, keeps his feet. Amazing balance and a first down.
Great run by Maurice Morris.
For the yardage.
I think it was
and paid off. He did change shoes.
He's played well on grass.
And he'll get the call again and a short pickup this time. Well, no question, there were a few slips in the first couple of games there at Austin Stadium. And the last game, we didn't see that happen as much, so it appears they're getting on solid ground. Second and 10 for Harrington. Going deep. Sammy Parker stretching out, but not able to hang on. And a little flare pass to Morris, and this one's not going anywhere.
Good pursuit here. They get around the ball. They read it. You see the linebackers moving out. They see him going. Just go with the flow of the play, and they're able to stop Maurice Morris. Again, though, Mark, on third down, Oregon not throwing the ball to the first down ball. Join Jerry Allen and Coach Blotti to hear the latest in Duck football. Tuesday night special, enter to win tickets for the next home game. If your question card is read on the air, you'll take home a prize. The Wild Duck, Tuesday night in Eugene.
And a high kick from Arroyo. And a good one.
Not so sure about that timeout from Utah State.
We'll see what happens. White on the carry. And stopped after a pickup of about three. And let's see. And White will get the call again. And just short of the first down, I believe. And Fuentes moving up the charts for Utah State already tonight. Has moved into eight in career passing yards. And this really... Eric Hipple, quarterback who's played here. Merlin Olsen, of course, the most famous alumni.
And they've got on top of the stadium some names, retired names. They've got Merlin Olsen and Elmer Ward.
Elmer Ward, the Bear. All right, here's White again. Second down and chase down. Leslie Mallard.
Oregon is going to use the timeout.
His first game at Montana beat Oregon State in Corvallis back in 96. Here's White on the carry. Prater. Tackled after a very short gain and another timeout for Oregon.
Only four in the middle. You might as well go after the block. See what you can get.
I mean, if you're the punter here, you have to be a little bit nervous. And a great punt from Mullins.
Returnable.
Back to the 20. Howry breaks a tackle. Still on his feet. 40, 45, 50. One man to beat. And caught from behind. And Paris Warren in the ball game. He threw a little option pass a couple games ago. And Harrington looking the other way. That's Parker trying to get out of bounds. And a great job of breaking the initial tackle. All right. 17 seconds left at the 29. Harrington will go deep. Parker overthrown. Freshman Keith Allen.
Watch it.
Wide to the far side.
Great protection.
And he's going for Allen right on the sideline. And a little bit hot. Maybe a good thing. Don't know if he would have gotten out of bounds. So 4 seconds left. And Siegel, a very powerful leg. Freshman. Got the distance. And it is through.
These scores just in from the University of Oregon. Rhodes Scholars, 18. Governors of Oregon, 8. Nobel Prize winners, 2. Average class size, 26. Student-teacher ratio, 18 to 1. Fulbright Scholars, 180. And finally, rivers running through campus, 1. Other places like this, 0. The University of Oregon. Let's go, Ducks.
Back with more halftime here in Logan, Utah, when we return. Holy cow. All right, time to take a look at one of the old coaches for the Oregon football team. Nobody more loved than Len Casanova.
Legend is a word that is used too much. A legend is someone who, through his works, has touched thousands, who in turn have touched tens of thousands, and on and on. A legend is Len Casanova.
All of us, and I think I speak with the same voice as a lot of the other guys, is that he meant a great deal to me personally. I left Los Angeles not knowing anybody in Eugene when I came here to play and go to school, and he became a father. I don't know that I knew it at the time as much as I look back now, and I said I really leaned on him a lot for advice and guidance, and I think all of us really trusted him.
Born in 1905, Cas is 96 now and doesn't get out too often. He recently made a special trip to the building bearing his name to see the new display created in his honor. It's a tribute to his years, to his service and dedication, from winning football games to creating winners in life. A tribute to doing things the right way, with character and discipline and responsibility.
Len Casanova was the foundation on which this program has been built. And the principles, the integrity, of that man are the lessons that we try to live by day in and day out.
50 years ago this weekend, Cas won his first game as the Oregon head coach. It was a win over Arizona, 39-21. For 16 seasons, he carried on while his players carried him off. Fierce in battle, demanding of his young men, gracious in defeat, and never blinded from the big picture. Very few men have the kind of impact Len Casanova has had, and the kind of impact he will continue to have for years to come.
He's rare. I mean, he's a rare person. There are not many people. He could have been in any business, and he'd have been a rare person because of the qualities that he has.
Every school has one for Oregon football. It's Len Casanova, the legendary coach, certainly leaving his mark on this program, and we celebrate this weekend the 50th anniversary of his first Oregon win. On our way to another Oregon win, possibly, here in Logan, 17-7 at halftime.
Maurice Morris, the 110 of those, so Maurice Morris really playing well right now over the 100-yard mark, and need to get over 150. They're on their way. Joey Harrington looking pretty good, 142 through the air, throwing the ball with a purpose. Last week, some of the balls got away a little bit, a little loose. Tonight, he's throwing the ball tight and coming up with some big plays as well. 260 is a good number for the first half, a very good number. 13 first downs, that's another huge number, but again, some crucial third downs, the only reason this game is still a 10-point game.
And how about the time of possession? Almost double for Oregon. Our halftime statistics have been brought to you by Budweiser. Well, Oregon has had to win some close games, as we all know, including last week against USC, and was very calm and cool on the sidelines. And Joey Harrington talked about that. He said the reason is because of team chemistry. Of course, this team has been together. They work out throughout the summer together. A lot of guys stick around Eugene all summer long. And that helps to create that chemistry. And that also helps them to pull out the close games like last week against USC. Let's see what Joey Harrington said about that.
You're out of energy. You're shot.
where we have the advantage is we are such a close team, and we do the summer work, and we spend that time bonding so that when we get out there and we're extremely tired, nothing left in the energy tanks, you know that I can turn to the guy next to me and count on him to have my back. And we get into those later games, and some of the teams, we just start picking at each other. We start moving the ball at the end of the game. They start picking. The DBs are screaming at the backers, and the D-line's not getting enough press. Everybody starts picking at each other. We don't do that. We pull together, and we pull games out.
Just a matter of, again, getting the third downs, but his percentage is up, and he's doing the right things. And I would think around the country when it comes to the Heisman campaign and all of that, he's doing just fine. Some guys are falling by the wayside. It's hard right now to think of Ken Simonson as a legitimate candidate anymore for the Heisman Trophy. Some other guys around the country maybe are stepping up, like Deshaun Foster. But Joey Harrington's kind of the even keel. He's kind of been there every week. He's doing what he needs to do to stay in the picture. So it's kind of an attrition thing. You stay in it, you got a shot to get invited to New York at the end of the year.
Well, let's face it. The games late in the season are the most important anyway. That's the one all the voters remember. Those are the ones. So as long as your team keeps winning, you keep yourself in it. All right, deep kick from Siegel. And Utah State will bring it out. And a good return across the 25.
A lot of these players, like Fuentes, not highly recruited by really any team in the Pac-10 or the Mountain West, and decided to come here. He's at a Rancho Cucamonga, California. Threw the ball a lot in high school.
And complete on first down to Curtis. Breaks the tackle, gets the first down. Out of South Jordan, Utah. Even more reason for the fans here to love this guy. On first down, Emmett White dropped the ball. And Emmett White, second and 10 from their own 39. There's the pitch to White and some running room. But intense on the field for sure. Big third down for Utah State. Fuentes has his man. And that's Gary Coleman into Oregon territory. Gang tackle. Made the tour of the country.
He's heard every joke in the book. You kind of feel bad for him a little bit.
He is a lot taller than the other Gary Coleman. Good pressure there. Seth McEwen. Robinson tweaked his ankle. He's questionable to return. Jason Willis. We saw the hard landing he took. He is also questionable to return. That's Kevin Curtis. 117 yards for Kevin Curtis.
Another good look at how Fuentes throws the ball. Tight spiral. Good catch by Curtis. Good foul.
They need another one. Probably to try a field goal. And it's White's big hole. And a first down across the 25. Utah State inside the 25 of Oregon. And Kevin Curtis will throw again. Going for White. Diving catch at the 3. Actually, his second pass. First completion. And Emmett White made a great catch here.
Keith Lewis gets sucked up on the play. It's an unbalanced line left side. They ran it earlier on fourth down.
And it's White. Right side spinning and scoring. Touchdown, Utah State. A 46-yard field goal to take a 10-point lead. And now it's back down to 3. His team took a 10-point lead into the locker room. It's down to 3. As Sammy Parker takes the ball in the end zone, and he'll bring it out. And not a good decision. Tackled inside the 15. And we'll see what the Ducks have in mind as a response. It's Maurice Morris. Across the 20. Nice gain on first down. Offensive weapons the Aggies have. It's not that surprising that they would score some points, but I think we thought Oregon would have a few more at this point.
On their feet, Oregon just 2 of 7, and another big third down coming up.
And another short pass, little wide receiver screen, and a big one, Keith Allen.
Better look at it. You'll see if Keith Allen has an opportunity to take it to the outside, to the sideline, to his left, our right, right here, but he decides to take it up the field.
First
and
for the Ducks.
Good game. Good game, good decision. Maybe cut back right there. Would have had one guy to beat. Going that way, you've got two guys to beat, and he gets it, but it's a big third down conversion for the Ducks.
And only his second career catch. So he's learning. Harrington over the middle, complete again.
Respond to a Utah State touchdown. Joey up to 186 now.
At the 38, it's Onterio Smith. Cuts it inside, got about 2.
There's the belly toss.
Belly toss to Smith, good block by Allen. And Onterio has the first down.
See it right there. You've got one blocker out there, the wide receiver. Keith Allen gets a good block. and you just try to get as many yards as you can. It's been a successful play for Oregon, and the rest of college football has seen that play and copied it and put it into their offensive scheme.
Tell you what, that play last year went for big, big gains more often than not. Teams are starting to figure it out a little bit, but still worth that time. Harrington will throw. Far side, Justin Peel, wide open, touchdown! Justin Peel, his fifth touchdown of the season, and Oregon is back in command.
And they do. Siegel is perfect.
You'll see Justin Peel out here. He's just going to release on the outside. But the key is the blocking scheme that you'll see here. We're going to freeze it for you so you can take a look what Oregon does on the blocking scheme. The offensive lineman just going to seal off this side, and then the two running backs like to shut him down. They step up and take the front side. You clear it out. Joey steps up. Great pass to the end zone, and it's a touchdown for the Ducks, and they've got a 10-point lead.
And what a gorgeous throw. Now it's up to the defense to get the ball back. Try to tack on a few more. And here goes Fernandez again, up and over and down inside the 20.
People good games and mixing up the offense. As you see, they'll go four wideouts again. Normally put one of these guys in motion, not this time.
Well, we talked about maintaining intensity. And Kevin Curtis has another catch and another first down. While talking to the people here, the other thing Utah State likes to do is run the same play out of six or eight different formations. So you get the same play coming at you a different
great
way.
Great young man. I love the way he plays. Runs to the ball. Big key for Oregon's defense this year to have David Moretti step up and play well.
And, of course, with the number on his back, big shoes to fill, and he has done that. And Oregon answered. See what the defense can do here. 2 of 7 on third down tonight. And Fuentes will throw for it. Great play, Rashad Bowman, and a flag comes down. But the official behind Bowman may have seen his hand on his back. Take a look here. Tough to see from that angle at their own 41. Pump fake. Fuentes throwing deep. Bowman is there, and the ball's overthrown. All right, second and 10. And Fuentes changing up the play. Looking near side and throws. Getting out of the hands of Emmett White.
As he comes through the middle, out of this formation again. They've run this play a few times tonight, but there's nobody there between Emmett White and the end zone.
May have started looking at the end zone before he caught the third down.
Not a lot of pressure on Fuentes. Team Morgan maybe brings a blitz. Brings something, gets the pressure on the quarterback. But rush forward.
And Fuentes has stalwart. And of course, the fans wanted to go. Smith able to recover. I tell you what, Stallworth is two steps further. He's probably got the first down. Fourth and about a yard. And the pitch to White and met by Kevin Mitchell.
Giving him a pretty good spot. It's going to be very close.
But Wentz is getting it done through the air.
Yeah, they've got him on their heels a little bit with all these formations. Five wideouts now, another man in motion.
And on first down, caught and caught again by Coleman. It's amazing. Like no two plays are the same.
Well, they're getting good matchups is what they're getting. They're getting wide receivers on safeties, and they're getting tight ends on linebackers. They're maximizing what they're doing offensively to get the matchups they want, and they're taking advantage of it. You got to give them credit. But Oregon, again, without AK Keys this week, you've got new guys in the game. Stevie Moore's played a little bit. You're asking some new guys to do some things they haven't done, and Utah State's moving the ball.
And here was the play that scored the touchdown earlier, and Wesley Mallard sniffed it out. Just tough to recognize what's going on out there. I'm sure very tough for the Oregon defenders to really get a feel for what's coming at them. And Fuentes doing a great job. He's now thrown for 200 yards, 9 straight games.
Utah State doing a good job maximizing it. Going deep here.
Deep drop for Fuentes. Deep throw, wide open, and caught. Casey Papinga, tight end. And a big gain down to the 15-yard line.
The tight end gets out there, gets free, does a good job, and Keith Lewis comes up for the tackle. But Mark, really, this is put up or shut up time, really. Yeah. They've driven the ball down. Both times they've had the ball this time
because it's a three-step drop, one play, and then the seven-step the next play. And here they come, and there the ball goes into the end zone. Curtis
on Fuentes, one of their few times where they bring two running backs into the backfield.
On second and 10, it's White on the pitch, and a big hole up the middle. Got about 8. Third and short. Fuentes will throw it. Complete touchdown.
It looks like he's the second guy in there. And a little pick play. And it works. And instead of switching, looked like Keith Lewis tried to get over there. And the extra point. Straight through the uprights. There goes the cannon. 13 plays. And Onterio Smith take that one out of the end zone.
Half until 3:41 in the quarter. Maybe take some more chances on defense, try and get the ball back. Got to give Joey Harrington more opportunities than just a couple.
Morris on first down, nice cut back, made something out of nothing, got about 6 yards.
The way they're moving the ball right now, there's no reason to think that they're going to be stopped.
And Morris is stopped. All right, crowd making some noise here. On third and about 5. Shovel pass, knocked down, picked up, ball is still loose.
The fans think it's a fumble. It's not. It's an incomplete pass.
Not a very good kick. Off the side of his foot. And it'll roll dead at about the 43-yard line.
Now you got to battle that, too. You got to battle the intensity. You got to battle the emotion. The opportunity that they feel. And the defense really needs to come up with a big stop right here.
1:30 and counting here, third quarter. Second and 9. Fuentes, far side, wide open, stalwart. Which I've never understood, because you want to know that your team beat the 6th-ranked team in the country. You don't want to think that Oregon was overrated. Somebody on defense has got to make a big play, a real turning point kind of play. As we head into the final play, which could be of the third quarter. Complete pass to Curtis. Rashad Bowman, quick tackle, and a short game. But that'll be it for the third quarter.
Good.
Kevin Curtis, we talked about him in the open, Joe.
Good play by Rashad Bowman to really set it up. Normally what Utah State's looking for is for Rashad Bowman to be playing a little bit loose here, because they're able to work their way inside. But you see the receiver come up and try to get inside for the screen. Rashad does a good job staying right with him and taking him down. And Mark, really, this is the play of the game right here. The way they're moving the ball, and as badly as Oregon needs to stop. Here they come.
Looked like some movement.
Prior to the snap, illegal snap by the offense, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot, the third down.
Oregon still dominating on the rushing end.
Entire third quarter.
And Utah State held the ball for 10 minutes of that quarter. Big third down and 10. Fuentes throwing. Complete a drop.
And a huge drop.
No question about that. Kevin Curtis, the national leader in receptions, had the ball, then looked upfield, then dropped it. And he just finds a place in the zone, just sits down in it. And he would have had the first down. Stephen Moore is deep.
Mile high.
Very high. And he'll let it go. And it bounces into the end zone.
To go to and check out, if you have a notion.
Onterio Smith on first down has the corner, and look out, Onterio Smith across the 40.
Got to look at it, Onterio using his speed. Something we've talked about a lot, Mark. Oregon getting Onterio Smith in the game with fresh legs. Here we are getting into the fourth quarter. You got to think that Utah State defensive line is tired. They've been run on all day. You bring in a player like Onterio Smith with fresh legs, down the field he goes.
And Derek Schenck thought he had a shot at him, but Smith just ran right by him. Harding steps up, throws deep. Wide open, Keith Allen.
Looks great throwing the ball.
And Keith Allen, the redshirt freshman, some big catches tonight. And another first down. Every time he catches it, first down. And 2 24-yard gains, 16 of 23, 237. Couple of scores. And Smith on the pitch. Not much room. Makes a man miss. And really did very well to get any positive yardage on that run. Probably not the same kind of thing. Starting to feel a little bit anxious about this one, knowing what they're in position to do. Harrington throwing, complete again. Allen breaks the tackle at the 10, down at the 6.
Oregon set up down at the 3-yard line. You'll see Joey come out again, a little half roll. He slips when he throws the ball, but is able to get the ball out to Keith Allen. Does a good job breaking the tackle. Now here's a look at the extracurricular activity. With the head, absolutely. That's the kind of thing we talked about before the game. Probably a little
Loving
frustrated.
On the defense, half the distance from the end of the first down.
Quarterback draw, Harrington. Stacked up. Tony Newsom in on the tackle.
Jesse busted
on that quarterback draw at the goal line quite a bit. Hoping to get a good surge from the offensive line, but Busta reading it, getting up there and putting Harrington on the turf. Loss of one. See if they use it.
And the give to Onterio. Good head of steam and a touchdown, Oregon.
Huge response drive. Another look at it. Onterio puts his head down, barrels over the goal line. Great play by Onterio Smith.
Siegel on. Tack on the extra point. Perfect again.
And Joey Harrington sharp to Keith Allen. Keith Allen in the game. Keenan Howry right now out of the game with some bruised or sore ribs. Not sure if he's going to return, but that's why Keith Allen's in the game.
Spin move, Fernandez across the 20 to the 23. And good protection, good throw. Emmett White comes back for the ball and makes the catch. And I tell you what, you talk about pressure, Joe, and he's just getting great protection from that senior dominated offensive line. Good adjustment there by White. We talked about earlier, threw for 500 yards in the game last year. Certainly has the ability. Evan White, short gain on first down. Well, the Ducks have, you know, had some players go out with injuries in this game. Amundson, Howry, and Willis on offense. Chris Tetterton makes his way off the field.
Looks like he's just cramped up.
And one of the more normal formations we've seen tonight. Quintus looking for Curtis. Has him short of the first down. Kevin Mitchell there. It's White. Stopped initially. Breaks the tackle. Breaks another. And David Moretti hanging on. Takes him down finally at the 35-yard line. 6 foot 10 inches tall. So certainly a tall order. Whoever's lining up against him tonight. As Fuentes looking deep over the middle. And some contact. I don't think that ball was catchable. And Smith and Curtis came together. And the flags came flying. Well, he definitely ran into him. The question is, could he have caught that ball?
Defensive pass interference on the defense. Spot foul. Automatic first down.
Already passed him. It was 20 yards past him. There was no way anybody except for the drum major in the band was going to catch that one.
Maybe the 6'10" lineman if he was down there. Way up in the air. First and 10, though, at the 20-yard line. And Utah State back at business again. Emmett White caught in the backfield. And Fuentes. Middle, knocked away and picked off. Garrett Graham. And out of bounds.
Take a look at it on the ISO. Here's Garrett Graham working to the outside and just working his way to the ball, no matter what. Comes down and watch him do a great job running. Turn the corner. Stops, works his way up, gets another 6-7 yards.
Tell you what,
good job.
Kick return next time. And this is not a very good throw by Quintus there. Looked like his receiver wasn't even looking for the ball. Garrett Graham was, fortunately for Oregon. They take over on the 20 and a chance to salt this one away as Maurice Morris. And you have to feel like one more drive, score any kind of points at all, and this one's over.
The play action.
Harrington wants to throw deep. Now he'll run it. And he will have the first down and out of bounds.
Kept the ball up, though, to make the defense think he's going to pass it. Right now, he knows he's going to run. Good block on the outside by George Reister.
And I think Reister was the original intended receiver and turns around and throws the key block. So nice play.
Practice that play a lot where Reister has to work the defender inside and keep his feet on the block. Hard to do.
Nice move by Morris. Still on his feet, being chased, and no one's going to catch him. Maurice Morris will score.
Okay, everybody, take a deep breath.
I can attest to it.
Great run by Morris. Look at it break up. How many tackles does he break? One, two,
three.
Kind of three.
And then
three and a half, four, and then he just uses his speed. Gets out. Huge touchdown for Maurice Morris and the Ducks. Takes him over the 150 mark on the day. More importantly, gives Oregon a 17-point lead.
And a breakout game for Maurice Morris, just what the doctor ordered. 69-yard romp by Maurice Morris, 175 yards on the day, and there go the fans, Joe, and I don't know if they're coming back.
A lot of time to go, 8-19, but Oregon really needed this turnaround, needed this turnover as the noggin knocker. Ball comes up in the air, and Garrett Graham does a good job holding on to the ball and getting out of bounds right there after picking up a few yards, and that really sets up the touchdown. Maurice Morris breaking through the line, picking his way, great vision right there, and then turning on the Jets. Five guys right there. Nobody's going to catch him. Morris goes the distance. 175 yards rushing on the night for Maurice Morris.
Well, that's the difference between the Pac-10 and Utah State. Probably would have been caught from behind in the Pac-10. Well, the speed out there, but Maurice, once he got out there, pretty much in the clear.
Good contingent of Oregon fans made the trip to Logan, Utah.
They're not leaving yet. They've got 8 minutes to go here. Maybe some more points. Here comes Fernandez. Good head of steam. Out to about the 25, and not bad. 175. Considering we haven't had a 100-yard rusher yet this year, Oregon hasn't. Fuentes will throw it, of course. Looking deep. Marshall Sanders, out of bounds. All right, second and 10, 25. As we head toward the 8-minute mark of the fourth quarter here. And the Aggies need to strike quickly. And Fuentes, under some pressure, gets it off.
They'll be throwing about every time all the way on out now, the last 8 minutes of the ball game. Here's Curtis.
Here's Curtis again, and look out. Curtis, across the 40.
You know, Mark, it's like playing football in the backyard. It's just throw and run. A lot of pad, a lot of cushion, playing soft, and you're just throwing it out there and saying, you're our best player. Why don't you go ahead and make a play?
5 years old.
They're still doing it. They're doing it effectively right now.
10 catches, 166 yards. For Curtis, Fuentes, looking the other way now. That's Subuturaga. Only his second catch, unfortunately. I wanted to say that name over and over.
Good closing speed by Wesley Mallard, of course, the fastest of the Oregon linebackers. Also on the Oregon track team, but good example of what Oregon will allow Utah State to do.
17-point deficit for the Aggies. Trying to narrow the gap a little bit. Fuentes looking for the touchdown right away. Stallworth is out there. Great coverage, Rashad Bowman. Tough to figure, that's for sure. On a big third down, Fuentes. Under some pressure, gets it away. Stallworth, first down.
One back set, traditional pro set here.
Fuentes looking at the end zone. And it is caught and intercepted by Steve Smith.
Pac-10 Player of the Week a week ago. Thrilling the Oregon fans up in the upper rafters. Look at the position. Gets inside. There's really nowhere for the receiver to go.
Wow.
Turns around and makes a great catch.
Well, that'll just about do it. Terrific defensive play by Smith. One-on-one coverage. And he not only had the coverage, but he made a great diving interception. All right, first down at 30 after a 10-yard gain by Smith. And he's got the ball again, up the middle again. All right, second and short at the 39. Smith again, first down. Got a couple, having some fun. And after getting kind of picked on the first couple of games, unbelievable against USC. This was the first one. I can't wait to see the second one again. All the way in for the touchdown. And he added a third one later on, a huge night. And he's taken over the Pac-10 lead, and Onterio Smith running hard. And he's starting to get pretty close to 100 yards.
Have to go to the record books to see the last time Oregon had two 100-yard rushers in a single game.
Might wake up and look at the score and think it was easy. This was not an easy win for Oregon.
They played pretty well offensively, but they just got bled to death with long drives. 15 plays, 14 plays, 13 plays.
Onterio Smith again. Fancy moves.
Mark, the last time Oregon had two players rush for 100 yards in the same game was 94 against Cal. Ricky Whittle and Dino Philyaw did it, thanks to our crack statistician, Tim Roberts, bringing in those numbers.
First time he's been called that.
And they're approaching it right now. We'll update you on Onterio here in just a second as he gets another chance.
And a big hole. And it looks like it's going to be a Lowe's to the first down. I don't know if he got it.
So Onterio, with that run, Mark, goes to 99 yards on the night. One more yard for Oregon to get two 100-yard rushers in this game.
He did for a touchdown earlier tonight, and he does again. Picks his spot.
Harrington on the keeper.
And he got the first down. Needed to get across the 36-yard line, and that's where they are spotting the ball. Joey Forster signaling first down.
Officially giving Onterio Smith 98 yards.
Should get there on his next carry.
And they've given Oregon a terrible spot on the play.
Wow.
I don't know how you spot it there. He was about a yard forward on that, and they're going to measure.
I'd like to see that run again. Maybe they say his knee touched or
something.
Mark,
I think he's short.
Well, from that spot, he is.
That's a terrible. It doesn't matter. It's 2:51 to go in the game. The only thing that is going to keep from happening is Onterio Smith getting over 100 yards, if in fact they are short.
Yep.
And they are short. Terrible spot.
Yeah.
Just terrible.
It seemed like from where the side judge was originally standing that he had it. See if his knee goes down here.
Well,
the knee's down, but he's definitely across the yard mark.
They spotted a complete yard back from where he is right there. That was interesting.
Player of the game, 175 yards rushing, a new career high for Maurice Morris, and a touchdown, the 69-yarder that really put this one away. And here's Emmett White, short game.
Nice area.
Pretty surroundings. Wasatch Mountain Range.
Just a little brown
dominating
for us.
Dominating everything.
A little brown for us native Oregonians, though.
Yeah, you're not used to that.
You know, during the course of his career, Mark, he's played better football away from Austin Stadium for some reason. He looked really, really sharp tonight. He threw the ball with authority, tight spirals. I don't think he really threw a bad pass all night.
17-24. Now up to 17 points. And that's fine, I guess, if the AP writers out east just see the score.
It really changed, though, when Utah State went away from what they were doing so effectively with their crazy formations that were really...
Over the middle, caught and dropped, and another flag. Maybe a little tug on the back. We'll have to take a look here.
There's just no contact there.
I mean, it's pretty hard to cover somebody without touching them at all, isn't it?
There's just no contact.
Well, you know, the Oregon defense does not want to give up any more points to this team.
Take one more look at it. Does anybody see any contact before the ball? Referee did, and that's the only guy that matters. So it's a 15-yard penalty, and Utah State hoping to get a feel-good touchdown here at the end of the game.
Over the middle, picked off Kevin Mitchell. And his knee was down. So no return for Mitchell, but the third interception of the fourth quarter, and the Oregon defense does the job when it was needed to do it most. Kevin Mitchell holding on to that one.
Well, Mark, the only people left right there, the Oregon fans hanging out, watching their team, a lot of family members here, a lot of road trip folks. Of course, so many great Oregon fans follow this team everywhere they go, and I know people going to Utah State and then going to Arizona without going home and hitting Cal on the way back. 3-week road trip.
Hope there's a laundromat in there somewhere.
I would think there would be, but what a road trip, huh? 3 in a row. Oregon offensively, I think, got a lot of stuff worked out tonight. They played very well on the offensive side of the ball. Joey Harrington looked good. Utah State put up a good fight. I know they'll want to work on some of those wide-out formations and do a better job defensively next week against the Arizona Wildcats.
Well, Mike Pilati's 75th game as the head coach at the University of Oregon gets his 53rd win, and he is 4-0 this season. The Ducks win it 38-21.